So this is our RSD patient. He had knee surgery what year?
2004.
On his right knee for a torn ACL.
And non-weighted cartilage.
And what?
Removal of non-weighted.
And removal of cartilage. And following the knee surgery, he developed pain. And we treated the RSD on and off. And the perpetuating factor, is that close enough, David? Do you want us to move this table? The perpetuating factor at this point appears to be gluten exposure. So he is non-celiac, gluten sensitive, with the two genes that create neurologic inflammation with gluten exposure. So he had gluten. Somebody lied to him about what was in the food last night. So he was up with leg cramps and knee pain last night. Today he came in, his right knee was cold and wet and numb and hyperesthetic. Okay? So I'm going to do a sensory exam. And you mark down the area. I need you to tell me where it's icky and where it's numb, okay?
Got it.
I'm going to start down here in your foot. So can you feel that?
Light.
Just prickly. Should just feel prickly. Does this foot and this foot feel the same?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm going to come up your leg. So this is L5. This is, RSD is in this particular case, do you remember what nerve it was? It's in Netter. There is a cutaneous branch of something here below the knee that the surgeon nicked. RSD after this kind of knee surgery is not unusual. It is why, if you've ever looked at the net of nerves that goes around the knee, it's amazing that any knee surgery ever happens that doesn't damage a nerve.
Isn't it just the lateral cutaneous?
It's not the lateral femoral cutaneous, it's tibial. Anyway, so I'm going to use the pinwheel.
There.
Hyper?
Yep.
Okay, so it gets nasty. Oh, this is permanent. Ick.
It's okay.
Okay. Ooh, and it smells really bad. I'm going to put ballpoint pen. That'll be easier, I think. Okay, and I do this in the clinic. So, hyper.
There.
Can you bring your, bend your knee and bring it up? There you go.
There.
Somebody get a copy of Netter so we can name this thing. Let's see if we can find a side to it.
There.
Here.
Yep.
If you have to open one, that's okay.
Is there one around that is already open?
I don't think so.
There.
Okay, do you see a pattern? The margin? You can't see it on the tape, but it's an oval so far.
There.
What's your resting pain level right now? About a 6. So it usually gets around a 7 when he gets bad.
There.
Okay, relax your leg. You're starting to kind of fasciculate there. Now up here where the RSD is, there?
Yep.
You can kind of see where the curve is gonna be. I'm gonna come down from the top. Really, Carol?
Is this one lying up?
It's going to be the knee, like below the knee. It's the lower leg. Ow. Sorry. Come down from the top. And you're going to see, yep, right there. Sorry, here?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
His eyes are
there.
That actually makes more sense. So you can see this place. It's anterior. It's right there. Or there's also
superficial
fibular nerve or peroneal nerve, and there's a sensory diagram. Here, why don't you move this? Anybody familiar with Netter? Ben, can you find, there's a sensory diagram for the cutaneous and the dermatomal nerves. So I'm going to come up here.
Okay, second bolster there.
What?
Second bolster right there.
There, second bolster. Anybody have another bolster?
Yeah, there's one right here.
Okay, around the back.
There.
So there isn't a cutaneous nerve with this distribution. So the field for the cutaneous nerve has expanded for the hyperesthesia. There?
Keep going. There.
Okay. Now, some portion of this is numb. So the numb place, okay. So it's going to be icky, and I need you to tell me when it goes from icky to numb. Numb is there. So the numb area is going to be the place where the nerve is really gnarly. Sorry. Numb?
Numb.
Okay. So the numb spot is here?
Run from there.
Here. Here.
The completely numb spot's there.
Numb. And this never goes away.
That never goes away.
That never goes away. But the numb spot that comes and goes with the RSD is here, here, here. This is where the nerve was nicked. When we find the right diagram, you're going to see it. So.
I think that's what you're wanting.
Yeah, there it is. It is branches of the lateral sural cutaneous nerve. That's the one that innervates this area. And the cutaneous branches, there's a cutaneous nerve diagram.
Okay, I'll look for that.
Yeah. So it's the lateral sural cutaneous nerves on the lateral side. And then there's this, it's a patellar nerve plexus.
It's a patellar branch of these.
But that's medial. This is lateral. So I'm going to go grab two hot, wet towels, I hope. Ow. So when you treat RSD, you're going to treat two pieces of it. You want to wring those out? I'm going to need four. Let's have two precision cares, because with RSD, you're taping this, right, David?
Yeah.
With RSD, there's always central sensitization, and there's always a central component. So I'm going to treat from the low back, positive. And if you think I get to treat this kid very often, you don't understand 30-year-old males. Okay. Well, it's been gone for how many months?
Two.
It's been gone for 2 months. We treated it a couple of months ago, and we got it to go away. Wow, these are cold. I thought I got it hot. I lied. That's okay. You prefer cold. Okay. And then we're going to need another one for around the neck. If somebody would take precision care, wrap that, the red and green So with this one, and you're hydrated, right?
Yeah.
Okay. With this one, you set it up, and we're going to teach RSD tomorrow morning. He's pretty fit. He exercises. We're going to take this to 200 microamps, 40 and 396. Polarize it positive. Starting pain is a 6. That's where we start. Then we're going
to
take.
Re-exam and change you to a 7.
After the exam, you change it to a 7. Soft touch is excruciating in RSD. So the pinwheel exam was bad enough. The fact that the pinwheel...
That's a shell.
This is a shell?
Yeah, that's the one you said was a shell.
No, it's a precision care. The shell is a 1300.
Okay, we're good then.
This one works. Okay, so this one, the fact that the exam aggravated everything, there is central sensitization involved in RSD. So you can treat the spinal cord without having to treat the affected leg. So you were asking, no, it was her. She was asking, Deet was asking about treating the opposite leg with RSD. One more, bartender? Oh, no, it's okay. There's enough water.
Perfect.
He likes it cool. So somebody set this at 40 and 10. It's okay. I thought I poured enough boiling water in there to make the ball. It was chilly. No, you're good. This one's warmer than the... Anyway, so you've got the red and green leads at the neck and central sensitization. Let's move the machine over here. That's why we have rolly carts, except that we don't have rolly carts. I almost brought that one from the garage. And so this one, and maybe set that on that chair. We're going to put on 40 and 10 and wrap it around.
Is that far enough over?
Well, what the heck? There we go. And bring it over this way. So this is real life. I got to tell you, it's wonderful having a real RSD patient to treat. It's kind of fun. Well, not for the patient so much. So you can wrap this around both feet or just one foot and push 40 and 10. Come on, Carol, really? I push the on button instead of the run button. Hello. Okay, 40 and 10 alternating. He has no spinal stenosis, just polarized positive. Now this is running on the spinal cord, and you can relax your left leg if you want, if that would be comfortable. Whatever you want to do. So this is the part where it's kind of like watching grass grow. You wait. The biggest problem is inflammation in the nerve. The fact that gluten exposure makes it worse. So his symptoms last night from gluten exposure were body pain, joint pain. His knee started to hurt. He breaks into a sweat. What was the other one? Was that it? Yeah. And that's what happens when he gets gluten.
How long have you been gluten clean?
2 years.
2 years.
2 years, and that was your...
Last exposure was in... Last exposure was in January.
Last one was January, and it's usually an accident. Either they lie about what's in the food. What was it?
Always an accident.
It's always an accident. Yeah, you don't mess with this kind of pain. So pretty quick. How's your pain level? Pain level's coming down. You can kind of tell by his breathing and his blink rate. You see, watch the blink rate. That'll make him self-conscious about it. But in point of fact, when they start to blink, what happens when 40 and 10 starts to work is they stay closed just a fraction longer. Normally when you blink, it's down and up. You watch the blink rate in post-op, right? And in pre-op. You use it to assess medication. Do the same thing here. His endorphins are heading up. Substance P is heading down. Takes about 20 minutes. Pain is 0 to 10.
Six.
Still a 6. So I'm from a 7 to a 6. That's nice.
What's running on that other machine?
40 and 396. It was cold and sweating today, so he's not denervated. It's warm. So that's an improvement right there. Is that okay? No?
It is
now.
No, I said it is now.
So soft touch with an RSD patient is excruciating because of the denervation. So you can I touch your leg? It's going to be firm and quick. Ready? One, two, three. That is okay, right? This is not. It will be excruciating. They can't wear trousers, can't wear pants. He went 2 years and wore shorts when this first happened. His knee just hurt. We had no idea he had RSD. It was blue, purple, cold, dry. He had hair that was gone around it. Kind of had the full picture. Hair's grown back. We finally treated it 2 years ago. I think it was a couple of years ago. And then we found out that the gluten is what made it come back. So, dum-da-dum-da-dum. This is like watching grass grow. What do we got? Cutaneous nerve. Oh, there it is. Lateral serocutaneous nerve is that one. And then this above the knee is new. That's kind of it, but that is it. And then that's lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. But not exactly, huh?
Could it be wrapped around?
Yeah, posterior. Interesting. So Netter is my friend. So those of you who want to go eat dinner can go, and I'll tell you how this turns out in the morning. But basically, this is how you use two machines to deal with central sensitization. So we'll do 40 and 396 until this one gets better. How's your pain level?
Four.
So once it gets down to a two, then you can start messing with it. But you just wait, literally. You cover them up with a blanket, leave the room. You don't have to be there for this part. It takes 20, 30 minutes to treat the nerve. So the pain's gone from a 6 to a 4, and I would be willing to bet that the hypersensitive area will have receded as well. He's never had any motor weakness. Some patients will get paralysis because it affects the sympathetics and the motor nerves as well. Say again?
My quad
atrophy. Oh, that's right. I forgot about that. So it was quad atrophied. When did that go away? After we treated it? Okay, so we treated it about a year and a half, 2 years ago, and I guess the quad started working. That's kind of fun. I forgot about that. And it wasn't like we treated it multiple times. It was maybe twice in the living room.
Well, I was in your office.
Once in the office?
I didn't let you keep it very long.
Yeah, I never let him. He never lets me keep him very long. Gotta go, Mom. All right. So we could maybe make it a little sharper. What's your pain level? Still a four?
Three?
So 3-4. So it came down half a notch. And the lights and the attention, he's still awake. But in a regular patient with a 40 and 10 going and the nerve pain going, they get pretty stoned, and they would not willingly keep their eyes open. So you could close your eyes if you wanted. It's all right. So that's what you do. When you start treating nerve pain patients, there's just a certain amount of patients involved. Everything we do here in the practicums, there's a lot of manual stuff. You're palpating, you're feeling, you're moving the tissue, you're doing this, doing that. You don't have to be here for this part. The current and the frequencies do this. And you just wait. It's like watching grass grow. You just wait. And I think what we're doing is that the voltage, the current that flows from where that nerve comes out to where the nerve ends, because the current is flowing, there's voltage. Where there's voltage, there's enough voltage to flip the voltage-gated ion channels, the calcium and potassium and sodium channels in the nerve. And you flip those things and close them. And you make the nerve stop leaking. You okay? What's that doing?
It pops when I'm able to move it.
And when it pops, it feels better?
Yes.
So you're shifting the reuptake of the synaptic gap is what you're saying.
That's what I think we're doing. Now, I have no proof that that's what we're doing. I want somebody who has a squid axon and a lab where you can flame the heck out of the squid axon and then you can treat it with microcurrent and see what happens. You could do it in mice and rats, but they have little teeny nerves. I think a squid axon would be really fun.
Does RSD have anything to do with why he didn't want his towels hot?
Say again?
So any reason why he didn't want the towels hot? Did it have anything to do with the...
Oh, I don't know.
I just prefer,
He just prefers cold?
No, hot really actually hurts. So, yeah.
Hot water hurts?
Yeah, every time you warm the house up, I'd ask you for cold towels.
Ow, that's right. It all comes back to me. I haven't treated him in a year. It's a while. Okay, now, hypersensitivity. How's that? That's okay. How's this? Tell me when it gets icky.
There. Is it the wheel?
Huh?
That's your finger.
That's my finger. What's it feel like?
The wheel.
Oh. So this is attached to his eyebrows, and the field of expanded sensitivity is about an inch and a half smaller. So it's an objective measure of his subject. Did that jack it up? No? Okay. It's an objective measure, so you can trace this. So when his pain gets down to a 2, the hypersensitive area will usually be compressed back down to this original area. And you just wait.
His ACL was repaired?
Yes. Yep.
And that's all good to go, except for this.
ACL's fine. We thought he had a screw in his knee because he's got this big bump and it's a bone spur from the tension on the tendon.
So, did the RSD happen after the surgery?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, the RSD is from the surgery. So, you'll see it tomorrow when we talk about RSD. The cases of RSD that I've seen. Some of them are from postoperative damage to the nerve. It always is some sort of peripheral damage to a peripheral nerve from some sort of trauma. It doesn't come from space. It's a sprain, it's a fracture, it's a needle stick. Blood draws, a certain percentage of blood draws result in RSD, like 3%. It's crazy.
3%?
3%.
Seems pretty high.
Seems really high. But I had one practitioner call me, said, I just did an IV on somebody and her arm turned white and broke into a cold sweat. She's not getting RSD in my watch and I don't remember what you said to do. So they came and got me out of the room and I said, it's not that hard. Just 40 and 396, 40 and 562. I could try 40 and 562.
Which is?
So this is on 40 and 562, that one's on 40 and 10. Okay. One's going from neck to feet because, you know what we could try? We could try this. Okay, lift up your foot. There. We could run 40 and 10 through both feet. Maybe that'll make it go faster. It's been 20 minutes. Say again?
That's what you usually do.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
40 and 562 now. So RSD is nerve and sympathetics. His wasn't cold, it was cold and wet earlier today. So mostly I think it's just the nerve inflammation. And I think the gluten upregulates inflammation, the inflammatory response in general. The gluten genes he has, his sister is celiac. He is he's got the same genes that I do. It's the non-celiac gluten sensitivity that results in nervous system inflammation.
And that was the swab that you...
Mm-hmm. From enterolab.com. It's the HLA. I forgot to tell you what test it is. We'll do it tomorrow when we get to the visceral stuff. But it's $149. It's HLA-DQB1. It is a genetic test, and it's just a cheek swab. HLA-DQB1, and they give you all 4 alleles. So if you have 1 and 2, you have celiac. If you have 4, 5, or 6, it's non-celiac gluten sensitivity that causes nervous system inflammation. So genetically in my family, the women on my dad's side all had they lived to be 92, but they were all completely demented by the time they were 80. Just gone. Didn't know where they were, who they were. Great, awesome women, but nervous system, and they're Italian. So they're eating pasta and Wonder Bread and French bread. How's your pain level? Hmm? Two? Okay.
Celiac's really high in the Mediterranean areas.
Say again?
Celiac is really high in the Mediterranean areas, and non-celiac and NASH go hand in hand. Got a NASH patient?
What's NASH?
Non-alcoholics, steatotic, hepato, blah, blah.
Cirrhosis?
It's not cirrhosis. It's like when you have fatty liver, but it's not from alcohol.
Right.
It's from fatty liver, but the fatty liver is directly, it's from gluten allergy and sensitivity.
That makes sense. I have one of those. And we treated her liver for inflammation. Couldn't get her better. How's your pain level?
Two.
Two? Okay. Once it gets to a two, you've got a little bit of latitude. So moving, I think moving 40 and 10 to his feet made a difference. So, where's my pen? Let's see what we got. Is it easier to use my finger or the pinwheel?
Pinwheel.
Okay. So, pokey wheel down here at your foot. Let me know when it gets icky.
There. There.
See the difference in the receptive field? This way?
Let me really...
This one?
Run that one, I need to.
Oh, this way.
No.
Where was I?
Was that like a reset?
There. It gives me a frame of reference.
Oh, yeah. You're supposed to always do the good leg first. So what we're down to, pretty close, we're not quite there yet, but the original numb spot where the nerve just is gone.
No, you went over. There.
So this is the original numb spot. Now, is this numb still or is it hypersensitive?
That's numb.
This is numb, but up here is not numb?
That's numb too.
Okay. Pinwheel?
Yeah, that's on.
Icky?
Yes.
Icky. So it gets smaller, and in a perfect world, if he'll let you, can I try something? Mm-hmm. I had one of my...
I've got an audience, you won't let me run away this time.
So huh?
I've got an audience, you won't let me run away this time.
Well, yeah, not running away. One of the docs, where was I? We're at a seminar, Hartford. He has RSD patients, and he said he thinks it's the homunculus in the sensory cortex. He thinks it's not just the spinal cord that gets sensitized or the thalamus that gets sensitized, it's the sensory cortex, right? Because some RSD patients will generalize, right, from it starts in the leg, then it shows up in the hand on the same side, then the shoulder, then the arm, shoulder, and it's the homunculus. If you look at the homunculus in the sensory cortex, it's like a person folded up, and if it's in the right leg, the next thing to go is the right hand.
That happens.
Hmm?
That happens.
It happens?
Yeah, my hand.
Your hand gets hypersensitive?
Yeah.
Always the last to know. Oh, you, yes. Okay, so I'm wondering if we ran, this is 40 and 10 to quiet the cord, 40 and 92, how's that feel? Good. So that's the sensory cortex. Forebrain is 90, Sensory cortex is 92. So we could do, if you're going from the cord, you're going to go up to the medulla, through the midbrain, then to the sensory cortex. So I'm going to do 40. We already did 40 and 10. I'm doing 40 and 94. Dude, that's kind of fun. You don't go smush very much. And 40 and 92. So you chase the spark. You chase the neural pathway. Does that make sense? So from the periphery, 40 and 396, 40 and 10, 40 in the medulla, 40 in the thalamus, because there's central sensitization. And then because it's RSD, it ends up in the sensory cortex. And I didn't know till this second that he gets hypersensitivity in his hand. Who knew? So now that we're doing the sensory cortex, I wonder,
I didn't know it was related. You bring that up.
It's like, who knew, right? I never asked you before because I didn't find out until the practitioner in Hartford told me about it. It's like, well, if you know more about the mechanism of a pathology or condition, you can treat it better because you know what to treat. Never would have thought of it. I'm going to touch your knee. Pretty much you don't touch an RSD patient without warning them. How's that feel? Any different?
Yeah.
Seriously?
Try again. It only hurt for like the first.
Say again?
Touch the kneecap again. Tough. It's like right there that it hurts and that's it.
That's it?
Once you get pressure on it, it's not horrible.
Better?
Yeah.
He looks very confused, which is kind of fun. Okay, so let's try the leg again on your left leg, on your right leg.
There.
So look what happened to the field in the last 20 minutes. Isn't that interesting?
I didn't feel like you get past my tibia. There.
Okay, so the now we're down to just the damage from the original nerve injury. Let's see what happens at the top.
There.
Cool. So all of the hyperesthesia that was up here, that's gone. It's icky?
Yeah, it's not horrible. It's there, but...
Okay.
I don't want to punch you like I would have 20 minutes ago.
Say again?
I don't want to punch you like I would have 20 minutes ago.
Oh, that's good. Not punching. The doctor is nice. And what's your pain level?
I've never said this at one.
Okay. We've never treated a sensory cortex before. Who knew? I guess I get to email Ben Catholi.
Yes, thank you.
Yay, Ben. Now, one of the last things you do with RSD anyway is you increase secretions, but you wait till the pain's gone. Then you increase secretions in the nerve and the sympathetics to get them to lock into the periphery. I've never done that with him. I've never gotten far enough. I just quit when we get the pain down.
And this is all polarized?
All polarized. Yep. All positive.
But would you run any frequencies to kind of wipe out the memory of the trauma?
We could try 20 and the cord. Who was it? Who was saying they used 20 in the... That was you. 20 in the cord. Just totally gone. Like, that'd be kind of fun. 20 in what?
In like
4 seconds. 4 seconds. I like that. Run what?
Custom care tonight from
PTSD. PTSD, absolutely. We're going to do 20 in the sensory cortex. Does that change anything? He's gone.
He did.
Whoa.
It changed it.
Whoa, that's really cool.
What was the second number?
20 on 92, the sensory cortex. That's amazing. Yeah, he's
That's crazy.
Talking until about 5 seconds ago. That's pretty cool. Awesome.
Now you can do whatever you want to.
Pretty much.
Give all those frequencies, you don't get a chance to run.
Are you gonna give us all these numbers tomorrow?
Yeah, tomorrow. Hi there.
Defo safety.
About 5 seconds into it. Okay. 2 seconds into it. I changed it to 20 on A and 92 on B, and you were just gone.
You said thank you, and yeah, like 3 seconds later.
You back?
Yeah.
How's your leg feel?
I don't know, touch it.
Does it hurt?
How much longer was that? Actually, I've let you treat me with like an extra 20 minutes.
Like that? Is that numb?
Yeah, well, it's numb just along that ridge.
It's numb there and that's it?
Yeah, and it doesn't hurt around it.
And it doesn't hurt? How? When was your surgery? 2000? So this kid's been in pain for 11 years? Okay, fine.
I'm stubborn.
A little bit.
Could you have an ACL?
Yeah, ACL replacement with the patellar tendon.
This is 20 and 89.
I lose the lead.
I don't think so. We got conductivity on both channels. You're good. Go to sleep. 89 is the midbrain.
What was 92?
92 is the sensory cortex. And that's, I gotta email Ben tonight. That's crazy. Never done that before. Awesome.
And you got it on video.
Yes, and we got it on a video. We did some kind of miracle. When was that? Three years ago?
Yeah,
we didn't get it on tape?
Yeah.
Oh my God, kicking myself ever since then.
That was the girl.
It was the girl with the smashed leg. Yeah, I mean, she went from not being able to bear weight or walk to walking normally in an hour and 15 minutes. It was crazy.
She walked back to her room.
Yep. Crazy. So I'm on 20. If you follow the spark from 92, 89 through the medulla for where we have brain parts, 94 is the medulla. Then we'll do 20 and 10, and then 20 and 396 and see what we get. Thank you, Tori. I'm so glad you're here.
My pleasure.
I never would have done that.
Something going on in your head?
Yeah.
You okay?
Yeah.
Okay, do you see the confusion in the face? How long have you been in pain? 11 years?
Yeah.
What's your pain level right now?
I don't really stand up.
Zero?
Maybe. I don't want to say that yet because...
Right. So that...
The color of the lights is different.
Uh-huh. So when you get somebody out of pain, that's the look that happens. That look. It's confused. It's, something's not right.
Pre-panic?
No, it's not pre-panic. It's like, if you think about what his thalamus has done, he's been in pain for 11 years. There's no pain there. There's no representation for his right leg in the pain centers in his brain. So, there is a certain amount of confusion. So I'm going to go back and treat the thalamus because that look of confusion you'll hear about tomorrow when we talk about fibro. You get a patient from an 8 to a 0 in 90 minutes. If the verbal ones will say, I feel as if I should be in pain, but I'm not. That's what it feels like. I feel as if I should be in pain, but I'm not.
Well, it feels like something is missing.
It feels like something is missing, yeah. I feel as if I should be in pain, but I'm not. So that sensation resides in the midbrain.
So Adam,
yeah.
You owe Dory roses and dinner.
Copy.
Check.
Thank you.
20 on A and 89, say again.
Favorite type of wine.
What kind of wine?
Red.
Red?
Pinot.
She's easy.
Little Pinot, it's good. It's resveratrol. Yes, ma'am.
Something that Dr. Feldenkrais says is that we act in accordance with our self-image.
Uh-huh.
So as we change, all of a sudden we're in this system and we don't know how to act because we
because it's
don't
different.
Have our same self-image anymore.
Yeah. And when it's, yeah, so there's going to be physical consequences. When he stands up, I'm actually going to have to teach him to walk again because his brain won't be able to find his leg without the pain. That's another, I know, it just is.
His brain won't be able to find his leg.
Won't know what to do with it. His cerebellum is used to, when I move my leg, it hurts. So if he moves his leg and it doesn't hurt, how does his cerebellum know where this thing is?
Can't help the cerebellum now know that he's...
I will. It'll get there.
Okay.
It'll get there.
Don't worry, Adam. I'm with you. Do not
there. Okay, and this is 40 and 89. If you watch his face...
Everybody stared at him.
Yeah, well, this is a part... Yes. Yeah. So this is 40 and 89, and you watch the face until the confusion goes away. It'll take any place from 1 to 5 minutes.
You might want to run a concussion protocol.
Yeah, we're going to need to, I'm going to send a custom care home with him with just PTSD protocol.
What's
right?
89
is the thalamus. Okay. You see the look on his face? Not as confused. Not normal yet, but you see the shift in just the facial expression?
Feeling of missing something, is that why he was grabbing, thinking he'd drop?
Okay. Oh, that's possible. Well, we kind of messed with the sensory cortex and changed it, so maybe. How you doing, kid? What's your pain level?
I don't know.
Okay, it's fair enough. Does it still feel like something's missing?
No, maybe.
Okay, maybe, that's good.
I feel cogent.
You feel cogent, not as stoned. That's good.
How does mom feel seeing her baby not be in pain anymore?
He's a 30-year-old man.
He's still your baby.
Yeah. He's still my baby, but the frustration of not being able to help him and not having him be willing to ask, it's been a thing. So I'll run the concussion protocol when I get home. I got my own work to do. But for the average patient, this... If it was an average patient, at this point there would be some hugging involved. When he stands up and he's able to walk and it doesn't hurt, there'll be some more Kleenex involved. And you just wait, okay? You just wait and you let them work through it. There. Yeah, it's kind of misty. 11 years, was your pain level at a 7? Yep. How's your knee feel?
That feels like fabric. That's awesome. Mm-hmm. How can you, like, drug me and make me lay on the table?
How come? Have you ever tried to drag you in and make you do anything?
Yes.
Uh-huh. How's that working for you? It doesn't work very well, no. So you kind of have to wait. Patient's ready, the doctor appears. It's not particularly a coincidence.
Can we change it to people that want to be helped?
You can't want the patient's recovery more than the patient wants it. So you just wait. Nowhere to find me. But the trouble with...
But, you know, people get afraid with pain because it's like we try so many modalities to try to help and there's
yes.
so many things and they don't work. And so the expectations, it's like, it's not that they don't want to be helped, it's... Who knows the myriad of reasons why?
Yep. And people are mean to them, and people accuse them of being whatever, and you...
I wore that stupid brace for 5 years.
Wore a stupid brace for 5 years. Well, at least it compressed it so it didn't hurt. But I don't know if this will be any comfort, but 10 years ago I didn't know what I know now about treating RSD. We got it turned off for about a year and a half, but I never did this. I never did 40 and 92 because until a week ago.
Sorry, continue.
I didn't do no 40 and 92 until I talked to Ben Catholi in Hartford 2 weeks ago. Didn't know about that. Say again, what'd you say?
That was it.
Yeah, didn't know about it.
And then that frequency.
And then 20 and 10, never did that before. 20 and 92 is what knocked him out. Just that's when he just went away for 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Who knew?
And I lost my ability to see red spectrum light when I came back.
You can't, the lights look what, green?
No, now they look like fluorescent lighting, but.
What'd they look like before?
Fluorescent lighting, but high blue.
High blue, and this looks more normal?
Yeah, this looks like the.
Oh, it's a sensory cortex. Duh. We treated 92. We really changed the sensory cortex? Okay. You don't think this stuff really works, do you? Seriously?
The girl we were working on earlier, she said she saw girly pink rectangles when her eyes were closed.
Who was that?
Esther.
Esther. Uh-huh. Okay, then.
But we didn't do that.
I don't think so. Yeah.
How's your pain level? Still a zero? Can I touch you?
I'm not prepared to say that yet.
Okay. I'll wait till you get up. How's that feel?
Touch my leg.
Same?
Pretty damn close. Oh, there's no muscle there.
No, there's muscle. Oh, maybe it's not as much. Upper part of the tib anterior is a little bit atrophied. Tib posterior is a little bit atrophied.
Yeah, you're touching my bone there.
That's this is muscle.
No, with your thumb that you just touched.
Oh, yeah.
That's the difference.
How's the bone feel?
Fine. I need to work out my right leg.
You need to work on what?
I need to work out my right leg.
Work out your right leg, yeah. Well, we can fix that. Oh, you've got goosebumps on the right side, not on the left. Somebody switch that to 40 and 562, if you would, please. Goosebumps are... 562 is the sympathetics. Goosebumps are sympathetic. So we're just going to write the sympathetics down because they're a little confused.
It's unilateral. I mean, it was unilateral.
Yeah, it's just goosebumps just on the right leg. If it was both sides, I wouldn't treat it. But the right leg, come on.
It's like the hair follicles. That was like what hurt.
Yeah, the hair follicles hurt. And the hair follicles are innervated by the sympathetics, and so are the sweat glands. So just quiet down the sympathetics. Is that better?
A little bit.
Okay. Take your time. I might be doing something wrong.
No, do it again.
Are you thirsty? You want a drink?
Yes, please.
Is that better?
Yes.
Okay. So you know the language. What tissue is it? What's wrong with it? What makes goosebumps? The sympathetics? How do you treat goosebumps? Quiet down the sympathetics? They think there's something wrong? Quiet them down.
That was the nurse in me.
Yeah.
Chris is proud of me.
Okay, now let's see if I can provoke some goosebumps. How's that feel?
It feels weird that you're touching my bone and it doesn't hurt.
It feels weird that we're touching the bone and it doesn't hurt.
That right there?
Uh-huh.
There's muscle over that and there's not over that. Do you feel that?
Well, you're in a different spot. So
there.
That.
There.
Yeah, there's no muscle on there. It's just periosteum, but there's no fat. Yeah, here's the muscle. So there and there.
Yeah, that part right there.
That part.
That ridge.
Yep, does that hurt?
No, that's what feels weird when you roll over it.
That feels weird because it doesn't hurt.
It's the difference.
Yeah.
Now instead of wanting it to... Huh.
This is a hello, toes.
So do you think this is a one treatment kind of thing?
Yeah, it is. Until the next time he gets gluten, we'll find out. But I've never done this much. I've never done the brain stuff.
What did he eat that had gluten?
Corn chips.
No.
Corn tortillas.
Yeah, corn tortillas. They said corn. It tasted too good to be corn.
They tasted too good to be corn.
Yeah. There was gluten in the corn chips?
No, they corn tortillas, but they mix in flour.
And wheat flour.
This is what you ask them if they're all corn, and they say, oh yeah, they're corn tortillas. And that's usually how I run into it, because I love tacos.
They lie.
Because she loves tacos.
Because what?
Because he loves tacos.
Yeah.
Soft-shell tacos.
Okay, so what I'm going to try in this one, it's going from your, bring your leg up, bring your toes up, contract that muscle. Any pain with that? No. Okay, what I'm going to do, once you get the pain to, and it's pretty much zero, yeah? Okay. So you're going to run 81.
You haven't gotten a real zero out of me ever. That's just ever. Off the table.
Yeah, I'm fine, Mom. Gotta go. Okay, this is 81 and 396. And while we're running this, I want you to bring your toe up and just contract these muscles nice and easy, about 50%. There you go. And when he does that, he gets little fasciculations. So we're just going to relax it. Point your toe a little bit. Go ahead and point it.
Fasciculation.
Is that okay? Okay, bring
it back. Fasciculation.
Fine twitching. Okay, relax. Bring your toe up towards your knee. Better. How's that feel? Different? Same? Huh?
Like I'm moving my toe.
Like you're moving your toe. Does the muscle feel any different than it did before, or is it the same?
Are you talking like before 2 seconds ago?
Before 2 seconds ago? Before 5 seconds ago?
Definitely before 20 minutes ago.
Yeah. Okay. So, I don't know if you can see this. Oh, it's finally settling down. When he points his toe up here, bring it up. You see the flickering in here? That's the denervated part. Relax. So I'm on 81 and 396, increased secretions in the nerve. 81 and 46, increased secretions in the sarcomere. Come on. Do me a favor, change channel B in there to 10. Hang on 1 second. And change channel A to 81. Let's give it about 10 seconds. Okay, bring your foot up. And relax, made it worse. Leave that one where it is.
Hold on, you take the towel off my ankle for a second.
You want me to adjust your fibula? He's just trying to get the muscles to pull the fibula out of the way.
Is that crutching?
Yeah.
I see it for 13 years.
Okay, bring your toe up. Better. That one's on 81 and 10. This one's on 81 and 396. Bring it up again. Can you do me a favor and change that to what, 81 and 84? 84 on A, 81 on B.
81 on B.
84 on B, sorry, 81 on A. So we had 81 and 10, so increased secretions in the cord. 81 and 84 is increased secretions in the cerebellum. So we're trying to reconnect this leg with the cerebellum.
Does it matter if it's polarized? Or?
Should be polarized positive. It is, isn't it? Yeah. How's that feel, Adam?
Pretty cool.
Pretty cool. Come on. There it goes. Okay, can you see? I don't know if you guys could see the fasciculations before, but they're gone.
Can I get an appointment to have you
get the scar tissue out of my ankles?
Get what?
Can I make an appointment to have you get the scar tissue out of my ankles?
Yeah, we're going to do that right now.
No.
Yeah. Well, what we're going to do...
He's back.
What the last piece of this is getting the adhesions out of the nerve. So this nerve has been inflamed and glued down for 11 years, right?
Does he have a Baker cyst, or is that just the way the skin's moving?
That's just the way the skin's moving, I think. He's too young to have a Baker cyst.
I have Baker cyst.
You what?
Pretty sure. Is Baker cyst a small cyst underneath the skin?
In the back.
In the back, it bulges.
It's a bulge. It's about the size of a ping pong ball.
It.
No. Okay, so I want to treat 13 and 396. Oops, look what happened. Goosebumps. I still want to treat 13 and 396. We'll take the scar tissue out of your ankles in a little bit. I just want to get the nerve unglued from the surrounding tissue.
So you typically wouldn't have been able to grab him like that?
No, couldn't touch this. And you don't do this.
I would be getting my pants on right
yeah.
now.
Gotta go. It's not even love you, bye. I just gotta go.
No, I still love you, bye.
Yeah. So.
As the door slamming.
Yeah, exactly. No, you can't touch them until their pain's gone and the nerves are quiet. Then you can do this. Then you can, and now move it. So the sympathetics have an opinion about this. You see this right leg? See the goosebumps? And it's only on the right. Left leg's fine.
So just
how's
on
that
the
feel?
Outside?
Hmm?
Are the goosebumps just on the outside?
I don't know. Nope, both sides. So, just need to quiet the sympathetics down. They have an opinion. All right, calm down. It'll be fine.
I don't know what I'm saying. Do you have a warm towel?
A warm towel?
Yeah.
But you don't like warm.
I was thinking maybe...
Seriously? That's so cool.
I was just wondering because the towel up top. My foot feels cold, like right above where you're saying I have goosebumps.
Here?
Is that
where okay. George will heat up the water. I'll heat up the water. Here. We out of town?
Is that
three miracles? Don't worry, I'm
working. Here, wait. Oh, that's pretty cool. And I can pour this into there.
Thank you for giving me a really little letter.
Well, you just got to get rid of this stuff, it just dilutes it. There we go. Well, that's actually kind of warm. Almost there. And we're almost done, for those of you that are getting starving. You guys are the ones that stick around and you actually stay up until 2 o'clock in the morning to finish reading the mystery book, don't you? That's this group. Let me get this towel warm.
Well, I keep thinking if I leave in 2 minutes, he's going to be standing up and jumping up and down.
Pretty much. That's coming. We're almost there. Now this is cold and wet, so we want this a little bit hotter than we should.
Ow.
Okay. Just sort of dump that whole thing on it.
Make sure you're still breathing. Is that how you do it?
Yeah. I had no idea what I was getting into because he's never let me treat him this long.
Sorry, guys.
Well, it's really kind of fun. What's that? That's 13 and 396. Say again?
It's a lot funner to watch it instead of just reading about it.
Yeah, and there's, it's so, I had an employee one time that had RSD. Okay, so you see the goosebumps, and you just wait till they go away. And so we used to have, as long as she worked for me for about a year, we had RSD to treat every time, and she had denervation, and she had paralysis. So it was really easy to watch the sensory cortex kick in and the RSD go away. It was pretty fun.
Because he got into gluten, did we do a protocol for the toxins?
The gut. Haven't done that yet. Your toes cold. Come on. Okay, there they go. Goosebumps are going away. Still,
I actually sit in the garage in shorts most nights until I can't feel my toes before I go to bed.
Okay, move your tootsies, wiggle them. So contract that muscle. What I'm doing right now is 81 and 92, the sensory cortex, move it. You want to reconnect your brain with your foot in a way that doesn't hurt. How's that feel? Weird.
I can actually curl the top of my foot.
Yeah.
Because if we're like at an angle, it'd be like.
Yep. So we found some of this out when we were treating my shoulder in PT. When we'd run 81 and 84, it would coordinate the movement, but when it ran 81 and 92, the sensory cortex, I could find the muscles. So the sensory cortex is really fun to manipulate. It doesn't take very long, though.
The lights are turning white again.
Lights are turning white again?
Yeah.
Is that good?
Yeah.
Okay.
And they were blue?
They were blue before.
Well, blue is a high white frequency.
Yellow.
81 and 84, 81 and 10. So there's one more step to this we're going to do in just a second. And move your foot again. How's that feel? Good. See how it just sort of relaxes when it does what it's supposed to do? Okay, so what we're going to do before we get you up is just one more thing with scarring in the nerve. So we're able to move this thing when you go for a walk. 13 and 396. So this is the deep branch of the peroneal nerve.
That feels awesome.
It feels really good, doesn't it? So inflammation leads to adhesions, so the nerve is adhered. Peroneal nerve goes clear down to the forefoot. You okay?
No, keep doing it.
Keep doing it.
You popped it.
Uh-huh.
Adjust my toes.
You say adjust my toes?
Yeah. One more.
What I do?
Just do one more time.
Okay. Why were you grabbing your hip?
Because I've been trying to get you to adjust that hip for 13 years.
Oh, really, you want to adjust the hip?
My muscles never let you.
Huh?
My muscles have never let you before.
Yeah, true enough. So this would, in a clinical practice where you didn't have, well, we've been at this only for an hour. This took an hour and 10 minutes. What did you say?
I said I'm a dick.
Silly boy.
Impatient.
Okay, so this is, and you're going to see in a minute why we're doing this. It's because he's got to be able to move this leg when he gets up, and if the nerves are adhered, it would take another two or three visits, and I've gotten greedy now. I want to fix this thing.
I do.
Huh?
So we'll be seeing you more often.
Uh-huh. This is true. Oh, that's not... Oh, my God. Holy smoke.
You're still on 13
and 396.
13 and
396.
Oh. Did you just move my patella?
Yeah. Feel it.
My patella is.
That patella does not move. I mean, it does now.
Wow.
Holy smoke.
Is it supposed to move that much?
It is supposed to move that much.
Yeah.
Oh my God, Adam.
Somebody better tell us thalamus.
Did get that?
Holy. smoke. Right now?
What's the current setting on that?
13 and 396. Just scarring in the nerve.
Wow.
Okay, I didn't expect that. I figured the kneecap was just glued down, we're gonna leave it there, but that was just scarring in the nerve. And the cerebellum said, you aren't moving that kneecap. There's nerves adhered to that kneecap. It's not going anywhere. Apparently not. Hi.
Hi.
Who knew, right? How's that feel?
I can't wait to see the walking.
Walking's gonna be fun. So here's the thing. His brain has a macro, it has a pattern. His brain thinks it knows. Now we've treated his brain, so it might be better, but his brain thinks it knows what the status of this right leg is. Brain is wrong. We need to get information, new information about the movement in this leg to the brain by a method it doesn't expect, okay? By a movement it doesn't expect. The brain does not listen to anything you do when you do heel-toe walking.
So is he gonna crawl?
Nope, he's gonna walk toe-heel, like a drum major. Are you plugging your ears?
Will I know even if I...
Oh, you'll
wait, yeah. Heel-toe walking?
It's just toe-heel walking.
Okay.
It's just re-engramming it, okay?
Okay.
All right, so when you get up, I'm going to take this towel off of your neck and try not to choke on the wires. And this. Oh, be damned.
Good, have them come off on your side.
Yep, come off on this side.
That, use every special, make sure that...
Just sit and put your feet on the floor. Okay, so what we're gonna do, if you move that chair back a little bit, we're gonna have you walk this way, and I'm gonna keep a hand on you.
Okay.
Okay.
I wanna go toe, then heel.
Yep, so what you wanna do is like a drum major. Your brain won't listen to anything that goes heel, toe, because it already knows what that looks like. So toe like a drum major, and go back towards the back. It's kind of a normal, back of the room.
I'm trying to turn.
Okay. And it's just like that. It's not lifting your knee, just normal stride, but land on your toe instead of your heel. Toe. I gotcha. Toe. And then as soon as you can, look up or straight ahead. Toe. Toe.
He's moonwalking.
Toe. There you go. You can take a little bit bigger stride as soon as you feel comfortable doing that. Toe. Toe. And you have to keep saying toe.
It's like the outside of my leg feels like it thinks it's going to pop out.
Yep. Brain hasn't found it yet. Toe. Toe. Straight ahead, just like a normal gait. There you go. Toe. Toe. And then stop. Turn around.
Toe first?
It doesn't matter.
Okay.
It's the walking. Okay. Toe. Feel the bottom of your feet on the rug. Toe. Toe. Toe, toe, come on, toe, toe, there you go, toe, toe. I don't know if you can see his gait, but as the brain connects with the foot, he's beginning to lift his heel better. Toe, there you go, and turn around. It's not there yet, hasn't smoothed out. When he stops looking at his feet, then you know his brain knows where his feet are. Right now, his brain's still not sure. There it goes. You see the difference in the foot movement? Can you see it? He's now lifting his heel, and look ahead if you can. Stop looking at your feet and let yourself feel where they are. Feel the carpet. Feel the movement of the toes. Turn around.
I don't trust
my hand. Huh? I know.
Trust you.
You don't trust it.
No,
well, that makes sense.
I said, I'll trust you.
Makes perfect sense. We will keep you from falling. Toe, toe, toe. A little bit bigger gait. Let yourself walk normally, but just land on your toes.
You're doing great, Adam.
There. Do you see it? How's that feel?
Better.
That just feel different?
Yes.
Yeah. When the brain gets it, it shifts instantly. Look up. Feel your feet. Feel the carpet. Feel the carpet. Feel the muscles. There you go.
Wow, that popped too.
Yeah. Nice. Toe. 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 Toe.
It's got more color on the screen.
Toe. Almost there. You see how it smooths out? Relax your shoulder.
Am I limping or not?
Nope. You won't.
It feels like I'm limping.
Nope. Toe. 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 Muscle mass in his right leg is quite different than his left. Okay, try walking normally, just like you would with heel strike toe. Just walk normally. He looks confused again. How's that feel?
I haven't been able to wear these shorts comfortably in years.
Because of the way it touches your knee?
Yeah.
And he's not walking with a limp. If we hadn't done the toe heel walking, he would be walking as if his foot was still broken, his leg was still not working.
Wow.
Come up here. Do that again.
What's that?
What? Yeah. How's it feel?
Odd. My toe moves.
Yeah. Toe hasn't moved. The toes didn't move before because why? The tib anterior attaches to the foot. Tib anterior is where that nerve went. Foot's not going to move as long as that nerve is stuck.
No skateboarding tonight.
Can't promise that.
Well, so far, he hasn't been able to break anything we can't fix.
No, you just wonder what he's going to do now.
That's not a challenge.
Yeah, really. Well, he's been snowboarding. He skateboards.
I'm going to snowboard.
Huh?
I'm going to
snowboard. Oh, absolutely. When you get used.
Did you say Monday?
Okay, where's my activator?
That popping thing?
That popping thing. We got to put
Chris
his fibula.
It.
He didn't.
Chris.
Crinkling sound's gone.
Yeah, because then you have something down the wall. It's slightly improved.
Yeah? Okay, let me adjust your fibula. Come sit. I haven't been able to touch this. Because of the nerve. Is that okay?
Yeah.
He's surprised because it doesn't hurt. Try that.
Try what with it?
Walk. Take it for a test drive.
The whole feeling it's going to break thing's gone.
What?
The whole feeling like it's going to break thing when I step out on it. Wow.
You should add a little music to that when you're
Who would have known?
You have been so brave.
You have been so brave.
Can they see you're not squatting right now?
Yeah. Thank you.
And what I said to him off the mic was, you have been so brave. RSD and fibro patients have a degree of courage that escapes most of us, just to get out of bed in the morning. That's amazing.
I want to
well,
sorry.
Thank you. Yeah, that was a night well spent. Thank you very much. We'll see you at 8:30 tomorrow morning. Yahoo!
I'll be in diagram three.
Yeah, exactly. That is amazing.